All right, so I want to try to put things in perspective. I thought the Kroger deal, I happen to be very good friends with the people at Kroger, was gigantic. But I imagine that a deal with Starbucks for a breakfast sandwich can be even bigger than Kroger. Can you explain which is going to help your margins better and which is going to help your bottom line?
Well, it's way too early to say because, of course, we're just a few hours into the Starbucks launch. So that's not exactly how I look at it, but I would say it's huge for us. It's by far the in terms of the number of outlets, by far the biggest launch we've had. And of course, the opportunity to partner with an iconic global brand like Starbucks is probably equally important in just raising awareness and interest and trial in consumers.
Now, do you think that given the fact that your competitor, Beyond Meat, has a close relationship with Dunkin', this was pretty much an obvious choice for Impossible to get the deal?
Well, we've been talking with Starbucks for a while. And so basically, anyone who is selling to any consumer who would otherwise be buying meat is an obvious choice for Impossible Foods. But Starbucks was one of our, if not the top target outlet, just because of the power of their brand and their ubiquity. And also in the 18 to 29 year old age group, more than a third of that population in the US goes to a Starbucks every month. So, it's just a great opportunity for exposure and trial.
Don't miss a second of Mad Money. Follow at Jim Cramer on Twitter. Have a question? Tweet Cramer. Hashtag Mad Tweets. Send Jim an email to madmoney@cnbc.com or give us a call at 1-800-743-CNBC. Miss something? Head to madmoney.cnbc.com.